There's two flavors of space junk. The obvious things are dead satellites. So they've been up there, their mission is over, they've expended their fuel, batteries out, solar arrays are dead. So there's sort of dead satellites. But there's also a lot of other debris, which is you have the rocket boosters that launch them into orbit. People are worried about, you know, debris landing on the ground or, you know, hurting somebody or property. But in fact, the sort of more significant concern is, you know, you have all this space junk, you know, flying around, and you have the most debris where you have the most satellites. You know, everybody uses GPS to get from here to there. We have satellite television, we have weather reports. You know, Landsat data is used for all sorts of purposes with, you know, governments assessing their resources, assessing health of forests. Farmers use satellite data for monitoring crops. If you have a piece of debris, you know, whacking into a satellite, in the worst case, you know, you now lose that capability. In February of 2009, that actually happened, where there was an Iridium communication satellite that collided with a dead Russian satellite that basically, you know, took out a, you know, $50 million, $100 million satellite that was working and you know, doing something useful. The Department of Defense and other government agencies contacted the national laboratories and said, you have these wonderful resources, can you help with this concern? We've got the supercomputing people, the modelers, people doing sensors so that you can go through and predict what would the radar see, what would the optical sensor see when we design the satellite system to supplement the current capability and enhance the current capabilities. There's about 20,000 objects that the JSOC, the Joint Space Operations Center, that is tracking debris for the U.S. government. And that information gets shared with companies and other countries. If they ever see that there's a potential threat to a satellite, they will notify the owner of that satellite. Currently, there's a disconnect in the sense of the things that are easily tracked are about 4 inches in size and larger. But things as small as a marble, you know, so about a half an inch, are large enough to do serious damage to a satellite. So there's somewhere between 100,000, 200,000 pieces of debris that we would like to be tracking. And so the supercomputing capabilities that we have here at Livermore are one way to keep track of that. We take all the information we get and share it with other satellite owners to, you know, basically help everybody out.